I studied biology originally in Munich, Germany, and I initially focused on neuroscience, but then during my PhD studies in Tübingen, in Germany again, I started to work on aspects of developmental biology, and I continued working on developmental biology as a young group leader in Dresden, and I started to combine developmental biology with cell biology and biophysics when moving to IC Austria 10 years ago. The reason for becoming a scientist was certainly the wish of following my curiosity in all aspects of nature, and it was also to a certain degree family inspired. Being a scientist was certainly a realistic option, and thus it was quite logical to choose this path of profession. The most thing I like about basic research is that you can freely decide what you want to do, and the questions which you're addressing in your work are sort of naturally coming up. You cannot predict what they will be, but you can focus on certain questions which appear particularly interesting and promising to you. But in essence, you are free to choose what you want to do with your professional life, and I think that's a big plus for doing fundamental research, basic research. You're looking at the processes by which the embryo takes shape, and you're looking at both mechanical aspects of it, which kind of mechanical forces are produced, generated within the embryo, transduced and received within the embryo, and we're trying to combine these mechanical aspects with the biochemical aspects of development. So we're looking at mechanochemical feedbacks in development leading to shape changes of the embryo during early development, using zebrafish as a model organism, a vertebrate model organism. We have contributed to understand how cell and tissue morphogenesis works in an intact organism, and we have provided insight into how mechanical forces interact with biochemical processes in shaping the embryo, and I think that's probably most of what we have done in these fields. I've joined IC Austria now 10 years ago as, I believe, the third professor who signed a contract. At this stage, IC Austria wasn't really present. It was more of an idea. The buildings were not finished. I chose it because it had an apparent enormous potential in development, and it was one of the few places where a lot of different disciplines were on campus on one place together. So the interdisciplinary nature, the potential interdisciplinary nature of IC Austria was the most attractive feature for which I have chosen IST as my new home. I think it's one of the few places where you have a campus university in Europe, where you have different disciplines on one place. This is one of the very, very rare places in Europe where you can really do interdisciplinary research, and that was the reason why came here, and that's what makes IST Austria special. Obviously, I cannot look into the future. I think IST Austria has to change with time. It will probably be bigger than it is now. There will be at one point also a generational change in IST Austria. I mean, part of the faculty will be replaced by younger faculty, and certainly a part of management and leadership will be replaced as well. So it's a little difficult to see what it will look like. I hope it will remain as interdisciplinary as it is now, having no departments and being as interactive between disciplines as it is currently.